Another important tool for analysis is Signal P server. Now it is important that we understand whether our sequence that we are using for our analysis or the any kind of sequence that we are using for characterization has a signal peptide in it. Now what do we understand by signal peptide? Signal peptide can be described in two ways. A signal peptide can be any sorting signal that is embedded in the amino acid sequence of a protein. On the other hand, it can also be an N-terminal signal that directs the protein across the endoplasmic reticulum in eukaryotes and across the plasma membrane in prokaryotes. Signal peptides are also referred to as ER signal peptides or secretory signal peptides. A question that can be asked at this point is that are signal peptides always N-terminal? Generally speaking, yes, as per definition. However, there are several sorting signals that are C-terminal. Example, the PTS1 signal for peroxisomal import or nuclear localization signal, which is the internal localization signal. So, it is important that we predict whether or not our sequence contains a signal peptide or not. Now, if the sequence has a signal peptide, can we safely conclude that it is secreted? No, we cannot say that. We can only say that it enters the secretory pathway. In eukaryotes, there are several opportunities for a protein with a signal peptide to escape secretion. It could be retained in the endoplasmic reticulum, be retained in the Golgi apparatus, be directed to the lysosome, have one or more transmembrane helices and therefore be retained in either the plasma membrane or one of the membranes of the secretory pathway, or have a signal for GPI anchoring, a C-terminal cleaved peptide which functions as a signal for attachment of a glycophosphatidyl inositol group that anchors the protein to the outer face of the plasma membrane. So typically, there are many opportunities for a protein to escape secretion. So, without much delay, let us go into the analysis of whether our test sequence has a signal peptide. So, for it, again, we will copy our test sequence and we will paste it in the designated area for sequence submission. Remember, this is an eukaryotic sequence, so we will have to choose the eukaryotic group. And we will choose for the long output since we require an image result for our analysis. So let us submit. And this is the result of our analysis. As you can see, the predicted score is very low, which is directly represented in the graph that our protein does not have a signal peptide in it. And it is classified under the other category. So, technically our protein does not have a signal peptide. It could have been as a result of the signal peptide having been cleaved and then the protein being sequenced. So, from this analysis of signal P, we are able to understand whether or not a particular sequence has a signal peptide in it or not. And we have to note down the value that is provided here and obviously save the image as save image as, we can save the image as a test plot and save it.